Okay. I don't think I got any new stuff from shopkeepers here. Still can't steal that forbidden blade. How in the hell? Oh yeah, you're probably still too strong to be able to beat. Yeah, I'm not messing with that. Not messing with that right now. Okay. Where... Yeah, this is where I need to be. Hey, girl!
It's good to see you.
Oh, there you are, dear. Well, did you find him?
Greetings.
We did. However... What do you mean he turned into a fucking statue? This is bullshit.
What?
The beast turned him into stone. If his letter spoke true, then yes. I do not know how we can bring him back, but I will find a way. I will begin by finding this seer called Susanna. In hunting, thou must never abandon the chase. Master taught me this. If I am truly call myself his apprentice, I must see this hunt through to the very end.
Oh?
Indeed.
'Tis true.
Ha! Huh. It's a queer thing.
Hmm?
What is? You and Santa are different in so many ways, yet at times like this, your eyes glitter in the same way. You both have the same steel inside you when you set your mind to something.
Truly?
Is that so? Hi, I reckon it is. Almost like father and daughter, you may say. Who the fuck's knocking at my door?
Oh?
Now, who could that be, if you'll excuse me?
It's Red Eye! Turned a bitch to stone. Yes, rawr.
Mm-hmm. Someone you know is, girl.
Oh? What the hell is this?
Indeed. Oh.
Eliza, wait, you're one of those knights Ardante, aren't you? Ardant, or whatever.
Thought I'd recognize that mew.
But...
No, needn't do that.
Eliza, what are thou doing here?
It's like this.
We had no word from Santa for weeks. I came to find him. In this most recent missive, he said he was coming to this town in pursuit of the beast.
I see.
'Twas the last I heard from him as well. Whatever happened here, you must tell me all you know.
God's a mercy for a hunter of Zonta's skill to succumb.
Voice acting, yay.
I would hear all thou knowest about this Red Eye. I fear I know very little. Nothing, even. The Knights Ardant simply bid me hire Zonta. They told me nothing more. But it is clear they must have known the danger.
Then why send one man to face the monster alone?
Wow, I was completely off with Natalia's accent. Holy shit. She has like a southern drawl, and I was giving her like an Irish lilt. What the fuck? Oops.
Not any man.
So great was the peril, they could turn to no one else. On the hunt, no one could match his speed, his guile.
His gambling addiction.
If they had sent a regiment with him, he would have squandered his strength just to keep them alive. Or so they said.
It is true. Our village wanteth not for skilled hunters. But even the best of them would only get in his way. The knight's judgment was correct.
But even so...
Yeah, that's a very different accent. Holy shit.
It leaves a bad taste in your mouth, yes. It is the same for me. By sending one man alone, we declared to the world our own weakness. Now it falls to me to hunt Red Eye in Zonta's stead.
Well, you should be careful. The thing can curse you and petrify you. Maybe we should find a way of circumventing that before you go off to hunt this thing that, well, the greatest hunter that you ever knew failed to do.
Hunt it.
Or fell victim to, I guess.
You have another duty. You must go and find the seer.
No shit.
Yes. It was Master's last command before the curse overtook him. I will find the means to free him of it. I must.
Zanta's lucky to have such capable friends.
My skill in the hunt is hardly the measure of his, but he needs me, and I will do what I can.
Just keep the birds off of him, that's all.
Countless times Zanta has lent me his strength and courage. Now it is time to give of mine. I shall send word if I learn more of this Red Eye.
Thank thee. Fearin not. We will save him, Master.
Yeah, we'll get him back. Maybe, possibly. Unless we try to lug him into town and then, you know, drop him, break him, then, ooh boy, won't be getting him back anytime quickly then. Hey, how you people doing? You like your possessions? You like the things in your pockets? They're mine now. Yeah, they're my pockets. Well, to God. Oh wait. That dude was 80% last time I looked at him. Which means that my thieving abilities have improved because of story progression? I'm not exactly sure how it works. You already robbed. You were at 80% with a couple of things. You're still at 80%, you bitch. No, 72. A former servant of a noble house, he failed to protect his master in his hour of need. He has since come to the realization that it would have been far better to have died with honor than to betray him and live for guilt, which still weighs upon his soul, is beyond measure. The fall of House Lander, I don't think I've run across anybody that has asked about that. Okay. Risk 80% on that fucking plum, though. Ooh, yes. Thank you, thank you. So some things have gotten easier to steal, but not everything. Okay. I like it, though. Gives me so many nice things. Don't think this is where I should be going right now. And... nope. Actually... no, you're not guarding anything, so I don't need to beat the shit out of you. What you got? Skirtnaz? 72. A man who makes various tools for hunting. While he's still somewhat lacking in skill, he continues to hone his craft, thanks to the support of his friend, Nathan. Ooh, now he's protecting something. You... No, never mind. I was going to disparage your name and talk massive shit about you, dude. You're just standing in front of that door. You're doing fine. Just fine. He once had his entire fortune stolen by a woman he courted, and has been wary of the fairer sex ever since, going so far as to hide his money and possessions in various secret caches. Unfortunately, he cannot recall the precise locations of all of them. Shit, okay. I'm like, wait, this town's a hell of a lot bigger than I remember. What am I looking at here? 22. I think that everybody else is still higher than Ulbrich right now. Yeah, Alfian is the closest one. I need to keep Therion in so he can get those purple chests. And Cyrus is... I heavily rely on Cyrus, goddammit. Although he's maxed out. Well, Ophelia, if I'm going to go with how I encountered the characters to begin with, Ophelia's will be the next one. Yeah, I pretty much have my party. I just need to swap out people every so often. If anything, keep Ulbrich in the team for the time being, but gonna probably be swapping him out relatively soon. You know what? I'm not gonna spend that little bit, patch up Cyrus, and then we can go. Is this just a gym bro streaming? What the fuck does that mean?
Harnett, wait.
Harnett!
Natalia?
I'm so glad I caught you. Here, this is for your journey.
There was no need for thee to...
What'd you give me? What is it?
It's a trifle, compared to what you and Eliza are doing.
Money? Did you give me money?
Santa was a good friend to me, after my husband passed away and all.
He kept me warm at night.
I can't go hide no monsters like you two.
Yes, but...
So the least I can do is help you on your journey. Let me do that much at least.
Thank you, Natalia. Just take the money and run. Or whatever it is.
Of course. Thank thee for the gift.
It's cookies. I baked them myself.
One more thing. Promise me you won't do anything foolish now, will you? Even for Zonta's sake.
Well, I did just kill the spirit forest guardian, trying to find him out there. So if you mean anything more foolish than that, like fight a god? Well, like a forest guardian is kind of like a god. Don't worry. I'm way ahead of you.
I will be cautious. After all, I'll be of no use to Master if I get myself killed.
Exactly. Good luck to you, Harnett.
Thank you.
Thank thee. I promise that I will return, and Master with me.
And thus Harnett leaves Stoneguard behind her. Her new quest? To save Xanta from his petrified fate. She must find the seer, Susanna, named in Xanta's last message. Though it be but a glimmer, it is hope nonetheless. And so she sets out for the Frostlands and the village of Stillsnow. It would seem that her journey has only just begun.
A chapter 2 completed! A healing grape medium, an inspiriting plum medium, and an energizing pomegranate medium. I have tons of those fucking things, but sure, why not? Oh, now I find the woman that gives you a discount at the inn. A woman who works at the inn in Stoneguard, though she entered this line of work in the hopes that she would one day meet the man of her dreams, fortune has yet to smile upon her. She has started to wonder if she would ever have had better luck working at the tavern. Well, now I got that discount at the inn. Son of a bitch. Alright. Where to next? You know? There are the Caves of Maya. I'm gonna have to check out these, you know, separate cave systems and challenge areas. Like, is it Far Shore? I think I wandered into Far Shore at a separate time. Nah, I think it's time to continue on with Ophelia's second quest. Ooh, hello, girl. Jesus Christ! Please help me!
Oh, it's you again. I'm still traveling the realm in search of my mother, but this blackguard suddenly set upon me and won't let me go.
Meryl Boston found. Okay. What is your deal, buddy? Scrutinize.
Hey! Did you think you can get away with that?
Forgive me, I did not mean to interrupt. Fuck, come on, dude. 72%! I don't want to steal your saber either.
Yeah, well, what's your deal?
A box upon you.
'Tis your doing that I'm a ruined man. If you care not for my words, then blame your own wicked house. I don't really... Oh, thank God. A mercenary who once served a noble house, embroiled on their behalf in a conflict wherein he lost many comrades. He harbors a grudge against his former master, so bitter that it threatens to consume him with hatred. Well, shit. Nobody needs that. Nobody likes that. You know, it happens. Yeah. Let's get to the nearby tavern. Swap out some stuff. Wait, where is the nearby tavern? Did I walk by it already? No, no, and... Apothecary, inn, weaponsmith. What's in here? Shit I've already seen. I guess the tavern's in the other part of town? I don't remember actually having to go so far to get to tavern. Energizing pomegranates. Good old Saints Bridge. Oh, can't get there. Just gonna go up. Oh no, not 54%. Shit, no. There's not many people left that I can steal from around here. I have robbed practically everybody near and far. Not literally everybody, just practically. And impractically as well. Boy, there's a lot of save, reload. There's the tavern I'm looking for. But on the way, let's just... Ooh, rainbow robe. I like the sound of that. 80%. Confident with 80%. Speaking of which, let's take a look and see. No new equipment. Some elemental stuff. Yeah, everyone's looking pretty good. Did I save or did I just swap? No, I didn't even save. Talking about it, didn't do it. Saints Bridge. Lovely. Now... Fuck. How much money I got? I got a lot of money. I can afford it. Fuck it. Although if it costs 10 grand per, it really sucks. Damn, everyone's hanging out around here. Let's change Ophelia in here. Yeah. Need the thief. Let's hear a tale. The first stop on your pilgrimage is the town of Saintsbridge, where a memorable meeting awaits you. Let us begin. Chapter 2. The story so far. Sister Ophelia set out from home alone on a holy quest. She was never alone. She always had Hannet with her. She is to complete the kindling, a sacred rite carried out every 20 years. She was entrusted with the first flame and bears its ember with her. Three churches she must visit to light their flames anew. Archbishop Joseph hovers now on death's door, heart aching for the father and daughter who accepted her into their fold. Ophelia takes Liliane's place, allowing her sister to stay at their father's side. Her gentle kindness inspired her to leave home behind and has brought her now to the town of Saintsbridge. May it bring a light to the hearts of the people living here as well.
I am Ophelia.
Greetings, Your Excellency. I am Sister Ophelia. I have come to perform the kindling.
Welcome,
Well, we welcome you to our parish, Sister Ophelia. I am Bartolo, the Bishop of Saints Bridge. For you to come all this way in Sister Liliana's stead.
Yes.
I am deeply sorry for the sudden change in plans, Bishop Bartolo.
Indeed.
Think nothing of it, child. I heard of the Archbishop's illness. You have my sympathies.
Thank you.
You are too kind, Your Excellency.
I have not been so blessed as to perform the kindling myself, but I know the pilgrimage is a trying one. Especially for little girls all alone.
Oh, I'm not alone. I got a bunch of badasses with me.
And yet, there is much to be gained for one who undertakes it with an open heart and mind. It will take every ounce of strength and courage, but for the sake of our church and our realm, pray see it through to the end.
Yes.
Thank you, Your Excellency. I promise you, I will.
The people of Saintsbridge have waited with eager hearts for the coming of the Flame-Bearer. The warm light of the sacred flame guides and shelters us all to the depths of our hearts and souls. Allow me to show you our cathedral. It is a humble little thing, but it's still better than that pile of shit that you come from.
If you please.
Behold, Sister Ophelia, this is the sacred flame of Saintsbridge. I stood in the same spot and witnessed the rite 20 years ago. At that time, the flame burned strong, but now it wanes and flickers. Almost as if it were sapped of life.
Could it be?
Do you believe it's some sort of omen, Your Excellency? Or maybe you should just refill the propane tank or something. I don't know. Fuck.
That I cannot say, but I do believe the kindling will restore our flame to its former vigor.
Please.
And now, Sister Ophelia, if you will, jump into the flames to I don't know how this works, really.
Yes.
Of course, Your Excellency. I will begin at once.
And she throws a little bit of wood in there.
O great Elfric, bringer of the flame. To you I offer my soul and my blood. With your first flame, I kindle this fire.
What is your blood fucking kerosene? How does this...
May it forever shelter the people of this land. Through the sacrament of the kindling, grant us your mercy and your blessing.
Oh.
Ah, see how brightly the flame shines now. Thank you, Sister Ophelia. You must be tired after your long journey. Please, take this time to rest and recover.
Thank you for your kind offer, Your Excellency. But since I'm here, I'd love to see more of your fair town.
We are in your debt.
You honor us, Sister Ophelia, but you should you not rest first?
You really want me to take a nap or something, buddy? What the fuck? I am stronger than I look, Your Excellency. I shall return.
Are you certain? I would hate for you to grow weak and collapse or some shit.
What's the matter, Professor? You look agitated.
Why, I'll be.
I never thought the day would come when I'd witnessed a kindling with my own eyes. I kept telling myself not to get overly excited, but frankly, I can't help myself.
So you've heard tell of the kindling before?
But of course. It is one of the central rites of the church, held every 20 years. The embers bore from the flame's grace feed the sacred fires across the land. Many people know of the kindling, but few have the opportunity to witness it firsthand. It shall be the experience of a lifetime.
Well then, now I have another reason to see this through to the end. Not just for my dying dad, but I guess your morbid curiosity, you weird fucker.
The bishop of this town's cathedral, he renounced marriage and instead adopted a young boy of his as his own son many years ago. Despite not being related by blood, the two formed an unbreakable bond with their shared love of the sacred flame. Fascinating, fascinating. Loose pockets as well.
Staff of Wonders? Okay, thank you, Archbishop. Damn, son. Can't rob.
Oh, no.
Don't want to fight. No, I'm gonna come in here and beat the shit out of these clergymen. Fuck you, dude.
Some moons ago, a ruffian began extorting coin from pilgrims traveling to the Great Cathedral. Word has spread, and fewer pilgrims dare make their journey. That scoundrel must be driven off.
So begins a tale of pilgrims in plight. Okay. Hey, old dude. What's going on? What's happening? What you doing? 54%? No, thank you. That is way too low. Okay, you got some fancy shit on you, too. Look at that wonderful duds. Ooh, what do we got? A refreshing jam. Can we interest you in some exotic butters? Maybe. Oh, that's a shame. Okay, nobody else to interact with in here. I was looking through, and... Okay, so... Oh, that makes the banner a little bit longer when you complete their stories. That's cool. There was... What was I looking at? I saw something, and it showed... All of, like, the quest shit I had. Actually, since I have you back in the fold... What job is left available? I need to find that other job so I can start chucking points into whatever, because your skills are all maxed out, aren't they?
No, they're not. Alfric's Auspices.
For 3 turns, skills performed by a single chosen ally will trigger twice. This will not affect other divine skills. Damn, son. I love it. Shit. Okay. So the main goal right now is just to look around a bunch? I guess a good opportunity to rob everybody I run into and scrutinize or judge them. Then again, I imagine going to run into something where it's like, oh, this town isn't as sunshine, rainbows, and lollipops and gun drops as you think it is. It's actually kind of a little bit nefarious and fucked up. But don't take my word for it. Listen to these people's opinions and perspectives.
This is all your fault, Emil!
We're gonna make you sorry.
I am sorry. I am.
You think that if you cry, that'll make everything all right?
I'm sorry. I said I was sorry.
Just run away, pissing your pants, Emil. That usually works for me.
And what's going on here? Break it up now. Break it up.
Emil lost Daryl's brooch. It's gone now because of him.
Yeah, I've been trying to steal that brooch, but I'm still weary about 80%.
I'm sorry, Daryl.
Sorries aren't going to bring back his brooch. You know how important it was to him.
Why don't you tell me what happened?
Ask Emil if you really want to know. Come on, Nate. Let's get out of here.
Well, at least he stopped bullying him.
We'll be back for you later, Emil.
Okay, I guess not.
Good for you. You better find that brooch.
Are those kids gonna stab you? Probably.
A meal, was it? Yes'm?
Yeah, they usually call me something else, but I don't want to say it in public.
I'm Sister Ophelia. I am a cleric, journeying on behalf of the church.